Boston, and a message to those who harbor evil. The city is strong, and its spirit can't be broken.
Best race ever! Thank you, Boston!
From excitement to tears.
It was just unbelievable. The people coming out, I mean, it was just, I'll never experience anything like it. It was amazing. I want to thank the city for all I've done.
The emotions were spilling over after runners crossed the finish line. The 118th Boston Marathon held a special meeting this year. The support was monumental, and the 32,000 runners didn't let it go unappreciated.
I'm so thrilled to be done. It is a real tribute. Those guys were awesome. It was so amazing out there. It was like a party from start to finish.
Vicki Miller of Portsmouth ran the marathon with her husband. Last year, she was trapped between the two bombs. She fell to the ground trying to protect herself from the debris. Memories of that frightening time are still vivid.
Yeah, I was very scared this morning to get started because I didn't want to do this again, but I'm really thrilled that I did it.
It's easily the proudest moment of my life.
J.R. Fallon was on the MR8 team, a group running in memory of Martin Richard, the youngest victim of the bombings. He's run marathons before, but the inspirational feeling he got from Boston stood out.
You only get that in America, and you only get it in Boston.
And that's why people keep coming back. Simphi Kulasa has run 11 times, and in all has run 92 marathons.
I almost cry, you know, it's like so emotional. I just want to have it done, just want to be here, enjoy the crowd, you know, they're all out here supporting us.
Another New Hampshire runner that we waited for at the finish line is Denise Bernard of Manchester. Last year, she was a spectator and hurt by one of the bombs. This year, she ran her very first Boston Marathon. Unfortunately, she did have to stop in mile 18 because of dehydration. She said she was sad, but she's not going to give up. And she says there's always next year. Reporting in Boston, Heather Hamill, WMUR News.